one of the biggest faults I kind of see is when people kind of take the club back, and what happens is they take the club back in a close position, and then from there the club enters the impact position and the ball goes too low. So here's a drill that's going to help you kind of feel what you need to do to obviously keep a loft on the golf club. So the loft needs to be maintained to create spin. So what you do is you grip the golf club first, and I want you to feel like you've got a really strong left hand grip where you can see two or three knuckles. What you do from here is you take the lifeline of your right hand, so this part of the right hand, you kind of sit that on top of the left thumb almost in that position. So the right hand has got no connection with the grip at all, it's just with the right hand. And from there, I want you to take the club back and then feel like you keep the right hand facing the left hand all the time. We're not touching the grip, we're just touching the left thumb with the lifeline of the hand. Take the club back, we're maintaining the loft on the golf club, come back. What you do to create an inconsistency impact, I want you to draw a line kind of going down the middle of your hand and down kind of your forearm, almost in that position. You see two red lines there. So one of the biggest tips I can give to any golfer, as we approach the impact position, the line on my forearm and the line on my hand should be kind of the same angle all the way through. I see a lot of golfers get into this position where they're in a cup position, and see how there's a big angle there and that line isn't in line. So if we get in a board position where we see this line kind of in the exact same line, so that's going to help us create a straight left wrist impact, straight left arm. So the idea is we want to return the club kind of back into that line of impact. The two lines are matching up. If we get in a cup position, the two lines aren't matching up. We want to kind of strive for a more board position in the lead wrist impact, almost in that position, so both lines are matched up. And that's going to help us kind of create a de-loft and actually the impact, more compression and more consistency. So one of the biggest faults I kind of see in normal golf is the left hip kind of slides too much towards the target on the way through. The left hip gets a little bit high, the right hip gets a little bit low. So I'm feeling to kind of have, pay attention to kind of the shutter behind me. So a lot of golfers who kind of get into the sliding position, the hips move excessively forward and they kind of get their upper body's kind of tilted back. So feeling to have, as we get to the top of the back, so I'm feeling like our left hip stays lower than our right hip, okay? So if we slide the left hip and it's too high, the right hip gets too low. So top of the backswing, and the feeling is keep that lead hip down all the way through impact. We're adding kind of more, getting rid of that kind of too much lateral movement by adding rotation in. So we're getting the belt buckle to kind of face the target as quickly as possible on the way through. So lead hip stays down and the belt buckle rotates towards the target. So golfers, do you struggle with transferring your weight on the backswing? What I'm going to do, this is a drill that's going to help you achieve that. So take another golf club, stand underneath it, underneath your right heel, and the idea is that kind of club's at an angle, that's a 7-iron. So we take the club to the top, the idea is we want to drop the club before we kind of start rotating. So I get to the top of the backswing, the idea is I'm going to lift my right heel off the ground, the club's going to drop, and that's my gauge to start the downswing. So as we take the club to the top of the backswing, we want you to stand, I want you to feel the weight in your right heel. And as we come back down, we want our weight to move kind of off our right heel, and we do that by obviously lifting our right heel off the ground. That's going to allow us to transfer weight on our forward foot. So you get to the top of that swing, lift the golf club, drop the right foot so the club drops to the ground. Weight's going to transfer left, and that's the key to kind of getting rid of this motion where we kind of excessively move too much away from it.